Hey guys, welcome back to Mini Urban Farm, a channel about gardening homesteading in the suburbs. I am really excited because today I'm going through our October garden tour. This is our first garden tour in this new gardening space. I'm really excited to show you what's growing. We built this garden not too long ago. I think it's been somewhere along the lines of about a month that we actually finished it, and then we waited a couple weeks and planted out things right before, I think it was October. So it's actually only been a few weeks since we planted out, and some of our stuff is getting so big and so tall, I just can't wait to show you guys. Let's go. So we are going to actually start on this side of the garden bed right here. So we have growing in this space, we have red mustard, which is one of my favorites. If you guys have been following along this channel recently, you know that I planted this out like I do every season. It's actually getting pretty big. These will grow really fast. By the time that, November comes along, these will pretty much be ready to harvest baby greens out of. So we planted approximately, I think it was 2 or 3 square feet of this, which is gonna be plenty. Now we also have in here some of our cherry tomatoes. Now these have not gotten actually very big. I did go out and thin them, so they were previously like 3 or 4 in each of these little holes. And they are spaced about 7 or 8 inches apart. Now, one thing I did not do at the beginning, which I probably should have done, is go ahead and fertilize them. I did not amend the soil at all. I was just so anxious to actually get this garden bed going. And Milo is very interested in what I'm doing over here. Hey, puppy dog. What's up? What are you doing? So I didn't amend the soil at all, which is definitely my fault. I was so anxious to get everything planted out that I did forget to amend the soil before planting anything. Now I did get some bone and blood marrow that I will be adding on to the top of these and the soil. So hopefully that will give it like a little jump start. Now I don't think I will add it to everything. I'm gonna add it to the tomatoes. Definitely I have a whole bunch of tomatoes that are still that small, so I'll add it to that. I don't think I'll add it to the herbs because I did manage to kill off my basil in past seasons by adding too much fertilizer, and they seem to be growing well anyway. But I will just kind of like top dress and amend some of the soil and fertilize some of the things in here to give them a jump start. All right, so besides my tomatoes and my my mustard in here, I have a whole bunch of lemon basil, and these were actually the lemon basil seeds that I had seed saved from my neighbor's garden. I originally planted those out because I didn't want lemon basil, and then I saw how amazing it was actually growing and I fell in love with it, and so I seed saved those and I have decided to plant a whole bunch of it out. So there is probably about a square foot over here of lemon basil. And then over here are my Marvel of Venice pole beans. Now I have grown these in previous seasons. I actually really like the way that they grow. They grow ridiculously fast. You can see I kind of left it for a few days and it's already trellising up the side of this this tether for this tree to hold it in place. So I am going to have to come and unwind that after this video, which I just noticed. So I will definitely do that. But these are growing really fast. I mean, it's only been a few weeks and they are like completely trellising already. You can even see it's starting to trellis about 1.5 feet up of our actual trellis. So that's a really good sign. Hopefully these will be really prolific this time around. All right, so now from the other side of this tree here, I have a whole bunch of chamomile that I just kind of like threw the seeds in here. So I've never actually grown chamomile before. I'm really excited because I love chamomile tea. So hopefully those will do really well. And you can still see some of these little tendrils having to be trellised, which is what I am going to spend the day doing today. So next up we have parsley, which finally popped its little head up. It took a while, but it is finally in. So these will grow pretty fast. You know, once these are established, they kind of tend to take off, and you can even see some of these little true leaves here already popping up. Next up is butternut squash. Now you can see some of them are green and then some of the original leaves are yellow. All right, I'm not too concerned about that because it has actually been pouring a lot here. In addition to me actually watering, it's been pouring in the afternoons after I came in and watered, so it has been getting a little bit more water than it needs. But the original leaves, I don't think you can see it in here because I actually fixed it already, but the original leaves were actually being attacked by leaf miners. I don't think you can see it because they're kind of like all dead now. But they were being attacked by leaf miners, and I managed to put something in the soil that completely eradicated it. Alright, so I'm not sure about you guys, but every season my plants, basically my entire garden, gets overrun with leaf miners. And that is something I've been dealing with for a really, really long time. And so I keep using neem oil and I keep trying to get rid of them. But last season, I shared with you guys in one of my garden tours last year. So I have found a way to actually get rid of leaf miners. So far, knock on wood, it seems to actually be working. So I still use neem oil. It is just the cheapy neem oil you can get from Home Depot, Lowe's, wherever that is. So you wanna take the concentrated form of neem oil, you mix it in with about 2 or 3 gallons of water, right? So there's no like exact ratio for this. I've done it stronger and I've done it, this time I did it a little bit less concentrated, which seems to still have worked just fine. So I took maybe about a quarter of the little, it's not like a box, but the little, I don't even know what to call it, the little container. And I filled the entire garden jug sprayer thing with water. So you take that, instead of spraying it on the actual leaves of the plants, pour it directly into the soil, just like as if you're watering the garden. So instead of watering the garden for that day, that's what I did. I mixed in that neem oil with that water, and I just watered the garden like that. Let it soak in through the roots. What that does is it actually gets in through the plant much better. And so when the leaf miners and the eggs and all that stuff try to go and, you know, eat the plants, it dies off from the very initial stage, instead of just kind of like hoping that, you know, it got on the right time, you know, the right side of the plant or whatever it is. That seems to have worked now 2 seasons in a row. It seems to have worked amazingly. I had a whole bunch of leaf miners when I came out here the other day, and now they're completely gone. Like, they were over everything. My tomatoes, my squash, even some of my mustard, my pole beans, everything. They were over everything, and now gone, I promise. Try that, and hopefully it'll work for you too. All right, so back to my garden squash. This butternut squash, I will likely be fertilizing this one as well, since they are growing pretty well. They have a lot of new growth on them, but just to give them a little bit of a jump start. The parsley I will leave alone because I don't think that really needs it. And I did actually thin them out. I know this is significantly too much for this space, but I'm kind of like just waiting to see how much I can get away with before I go and thin it out. It pains me to have to actually pop those out of the soil. So over here, that is still more parsley. They kind of just like made their way and scattered over here, so I'm not too concerned. And then this is my arugula. Now this arugula has been growing really fast. It was one of the very first things to pop up. You can see they are starting to get some pretty big leaves on them. By the time that November hits, I will be harvesting these for salad greens. So that I'm really excited about. And then over here, you can see my these are my Roma tomatoes, right? And you can see they still need a little bit of help. They do have true leaves. They're not as big as I would have hoped. There's like a little extra baby one that's a volunteer, and then some arugula that migrated this way. But they still need some additional help. So I am going to be fertilizing those ones as well. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you can tell these ones are actually like really tiny. Yeah, they need some help here. So we're gonna fertilize them and hope them, and hopefully that gives them like a jump start. All right, so I don't think there's actually anything planted in here. I don't know if I forgot to plant here, or maybe whatever it was didn't grow, but there would have been some sort of leaves popping up through the soil already, and this is kind of like just a stray arugula. So yeah, I might come in here and maybe, you know, add some more basil once I thin them out. But over here, this is my Genovese basil. These are basil seeds that I seed saved, and you can see some little weeds in here that I kind of just tend to get rid of as I go, popping up through the soil, which is fine. Not super concerned, but I do have quite a few Genovese basil. Again, I just like sprinkled them over the top of the soil and let them do their thing. So hopefully we will have a good harvest of basil this season. All right, so moving on, this is my Swiss chard. And this Swiss chard, I think it's just like the regular standard one that's like with the red, as you can see in there. Those red like stems. I have not thinned them yet. I know that I will need to thin them because when I planted them, I had, I think it was like 3 or 4 seeds in each hole. And of course, each one of these seeds is a little seed pod. So it grew a whole bunch of Swiss chard. So I will need to thin them, but I'm waiting until they get maybe a tiny bit bigger. It really does, you guys, pain me to have to go and clip off seedlings. Alright, and right behind it is my kale. I think this season I tried like blue dazzling kale, something like that. And I just come in here and get rid of some of these little grass seedlings at the same time. But so far the kale's been really good. I don't think it's been eaten by anything. I don't even see leaf miners on it. So far, so good. And they are starting to get pretty big at the same time. So definitely excited for my kale. Alright, and so my bush beans. Now here is where you can see a whole bunch of that leaf miner damage. Alright, like this is crazy. Alright, I mean this was all overrun by leaf miners, and you can tell it's like dried out and brown because the leaf miners have been killed off. Alright, there are like tiny little traces back there of leaf miners, but for the most part the plant is doing a great job of ridding itself of leaf miners. So I'm definitely excited about that trick I shared with you guys. Alright, so we have over here, we have an entire row of bush beans. Milo over there throwing a little temper tantrum that no one's paying attention to him. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Alright, so back to the bush beans. We have an entire row. This is about 6 feet of bush beans. I want to say there's something like 40 or 50 plants in here. I didn't really count. And then right behind it, there's some straggling kale that we just kind of like threw the seeds in. And then over here are my bumblebee, I think it's bumblebee tomatoes, like striped little cherry tomatoes, which also need a whole bunch of help. So hopefully once I put the fertilizer in, those will do much better. You can also see I did sprinkle like some parsley, which are like these little green, these are parsley. There's some kale, I guess the wind blew some of the kale. And then the little ones that have like the little pointy leaves, those are parsley as well. I did sprinkle the parsley just so that it kind of like interplants, which I want it to do. And then we have everything that needs trellising, pretty much with the exception of the kale and the arugula, up on the trellis so that it can grow tall. Alright, so that is pretty much it for our October garden tour. You can see everything is still pretty oh my god, it's still pretty much in the process of getting itself established, but we are well on our way to a fall harvest. Once these things kind of die off in a few months, I will be succession planting out some of my root crops, which is why you don't see them growing in here yet. For more urban gardening homesteading videos, be sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!